I'm Charles Duncan. I'm the executive director of the Richard Pousette-Dart Foundation, and this is the first exhibition, solo exhibition of Richard Pousette-Dart's work at Pace Gallery in London. This is following up on the heels of a exhibition we did at Kettle's Yard in Cambridge, which was a scholarly exhibition that looked at a sort of overview of his career. Here we're focusing on two different periods, the 1940s, and then some later paintings from the 1960s to the end of his life in 1992.
Can you just talk us a little bit about what kind of artist Richard was and what visitors can expect to see when they come here?
Well, Richard Pousette-Dart is mostly known as an abstract expressionist painter. He began very young, and he was part of the group with Jackson Pollock, Mark Rothko, and so on in the 1940s and the 1950s that really brought American art to the forefront in the world. But unlike a lot of those colleagues, he lived a lot longer. He lived until 1992. And what we do see is a change in his work to sort of an all-over paintings. He was also a teacher. He was Christopher World's teacher. He was Ai Weiwei's teacher. And he believed in the spiritual transformation of people through making art and the art-making process in general.
So can you just talk to us about the pieces that you've selected for this exhibition and why you think they go together and why it's important that they're all together in this particular setting?
Well, certainly going together is a huge part. The hang in this gallery, we don't just hang pictures next to each other because of size or because we're going around the room. All these works really, really have to talk to each other. So in this outside room, which have large-scale paintings, but as you can see, they're made from all over dot process. Some of them are implosions. Some of them are all over fields. But there's a harmony between colors, between all these paintings, between shapes, and they kind of speak together in almost a vibrating musical way in this outer gallery. In the inner gallery with the 1940s works, we have one major painting and a couple of drawings on each side that show his work in the early 1940s when he's emerging as an abstract expressionist painter.
And what is it that you want people to kind of get from this and feel from this when they're walking around and to take home with them?
Well, I think feel is the right word. Richard Pousette-Dart, again, really believed that art had a spiritual nature to it. I would say that these works don't do so well in reproduction. You have to stand in front of them. They're very dense and complex. What looks like it's a white painting or a red painting when you get in front of it has a lot of detail and other color that really make this these works kind of vibrate and sing together. They really demand a lot of time. They're like music. There's a sense of duration to looking at a Richard Pousette-Dart painting. You don't just come in and get it right away. So I'd encourage anyone who wants to come spend serious time in front of the paintings. And the first painting that you like in the exhibition is not the one you're going to like the best at the end. It's all going to change for you. So.
And just talk to me a little bit about how you find the exhibition space. What do you love about Pace Gallery in particular, and why did you choose this gallery in order to show the artwork?
Well, Pace has, it's a beautiful large space. It's an elegant space here in the back of the Royal Academy. We couldn't think of anything better. It's both historic and cutting edge at the same time, and I think that's Richard Pousette-Dart in a nutshell.
So. And just finally, just talk to us a little bit about kind of your role in the foundation and what it is that the foundation does.
Well, Richard died in 1992, so I oversee his legacy along with the family. So we do things like exhibitions and oversee scholarship, and the foundation itself also supports the arts through grants to other arts organizations within education. So he was a very diverse artist with a lot of large output. He did photography, he did sculpture, so we oversee all that material, but especially paintings, and that's what we're featuring here, mostly paintings and drawings in this exhibition in London right now.